This crazy old star is challenging the Big Bang Theory. The Big Bang Theory is a cornerstone of cosmology, explaining the universe's origin around 13.8 billion years ago. It is one of the most famous theories ever conceived, and it's not easy to prove wrong, because it is supported by evidence like the cosmic microwave background radiation and Hubble's law. This fantastic theory accurately predicts the abundance of light elements such as hydrogen and helium, and describes the universe's expanding nature. Observations of large-scale structures and the redshift of light from galaxies also align with its predictions. Challenging the Big Bang Theory would cause great concern and sleepless nights for astronomers and scientists, as it would necessitate the development of an entirely new theory almost from scratch. So could there be something that disproves this theory? Some speculate that Methuselah, an ancient star, may predate the universe itself. Keep watching the video to delve deeper into this intriguing topic. Age of the Universe. Dating the Big Bang has always been of paramount importance among the scientific community. Astronomers determine the age of the universe using a combination of observations and scientific calculations. They focused on studying the oldest objects they could find in the cosmos, which are stars and galaxies. First, they looked for the oldest stars. Stars, like people, have lifetimes. When a star is born, it starts shining, but eventually it runs out of fuel and stops shining. By studying the oldest stars they could find, astronomers got an idea of how long stars have been around in our universe. If you're wondering how they found the oldest stars in the universe, don't worry. We'll get back to this very soon, and you'll have your doubts cleared out. Just bear with me for a second. The thing is, stars are not enough when you want to determine the true age of the universe. So, they looked at the cosmic microwave background radiation. This is like a faint glow spread throughout the universe. It's like a picture of how the universe looked when it was very young. It is the best piece of information allowing us to learn about the early days of the cosmos when the universe was just a baby. But there's even more. They also managed to measure how fast the universe is expanding. Imagine a balloon with dots on it. As you blow up the balloon, the dots move away from each other. The same thing happens in the universe. Galaxies are moving away from each other. By measuring this movement through the study of supernovae and looking back in time, scientists could estimate when everything started from one point. Putting all these pieces together, astronomers calculated that the universe is about 13.8 billion years old. This is unimaginably old. The number is so huge that you would have to live, die, and resurrect 138 million times, assuming that you managed to live up to 100 years. 13.8 billion years. This is the best estimate we have based on the evidence we've gathered from studying stars, galaxies, and the radiation left over from the Big Bang. It seems really impossible for anything to be this old, doesn't it? Yet there are stars that are almost as old as the universe. They formed very soon after the Big Bang. One of these is the famous Methuselah star that could in principle challenge the Big Bang theory. However, we need to answer a question first. How do astronomers really compute the age of a star? What does it take to estimate how old it is? Age of stars. Now, I know stars are some balls of gas that shine in the universe, burning elements and fusing them into heavier ones as time passes by. However, I want you to think of them as huge cosmic clocks, for which it is really hard to figure out how long they've been ticking. How do you understand for how long a clock has been ticking? You must be a really good detective. First of all, astronomers study the brightness and color of the star under examination. The universe is filled with both faint and luminous stars. Moreover, some are reddish, others are more bluish. It might seem crazy, but the color of a star is strongly related to its age. For instance, blue stars are often associated with younger ones. Redder stars are representative of old stars. To be more specific, scientists use something called a Hertzsprung-Russell HR diagram, which is like a special chart for stars. It sorts them based on color and brightness. By comparing a star's position on this chart to others, astronomers can estimate its age. It's a bit like guessing someone's age by looking at their photo among a bunch of people. But this is not enough. The good astronomers try to come up with models describing the life of a star. They noticed every star goes through some life stages, just like every person does here on Earth. There's the baby star, known as a protostar, that grows up to become an adult. Most stars in the universe are actually found to be at this stage, and their position on the HR diagram is a well-defined one. Such stars are called main-sequence stars. We could say they are the average stars in the universe. Eventually, stars either die young or become seniors, like red giants or white dwarfs. By figuring out which stage a star is in, astronomers can work out how long it's been around. Of course, in order to do this, a theory of stellar evolution together with very good models has to be developed. Methuselah. The Methuselah star, also known by the very boring name HD 140283, has been the subject of significant interest and debate regarding its age estimation over the years. Everything started in 1912 when it was first cataloged. Astronomers from the Mount Wilson Observatory noted it lay only 190 light years from Earth. Early estimates suggested that this star might be older than the universe itself, which would have been a major puzzle for astrophysicists. They claimed it might be between 1 and 2 billion years older than the Big Bang. In 2013, a more accurate measurement using data from our dear Hubble Space Telescope revised the star's age estimate, which turned out to be 14.46 billion years old. This was surprising because it seemingly contradicted the known age of the universe again. Indeed, as we mentioned earlier, the universe is thought to be 13.8 billion years old. So how can we explain this difference? Is the Big Bang theory about to be disproven? Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Uncertainties. It's important to know that estimating the age of stars can be a complex process, and various factors like uncertainties in stellar models and measurements can contribute to discrepancies. In 2013, scientists thought Methuselah might be older than the whole universe. That's like saying someone is older than their own birthday. However, different teams of scientists took a crack at guessing Methuselah's age, and they came up with different numbers. In 2015, some said it was around 13.7 billion years old. Then in 2021, others suggested it might be even younger at 12 billion years. Now here's the real kicker. Even when we say Methuselah is about 14.45 billion years old, there's a margin of error of about 0.8 billion years. This means that the actual age of the star is somewhere between 13.65 and 15.25 billion years. More technically, there's a 70% chance that the actual age of the star is within that range and a 30% chance that it is outside of it. This further means that there is a 15% chance that the actual age of HD 140283 is less than 13.65 billion years. In other words, Methuselah could be older, but also younger than first thought. Scientists tend to say it could actually be younger, which makes sense because a star can't be older than the party it was born at. This whole debate isn't shaking up the scientific world too much. It's mainly a topic for folks who love to challenge the Big Bang theory. Population 1, 2, 3. So where do these uncertainties come from exactly? It's about the measurements from the ground. You should not forget that we can only get the age of a star by taking measurements. This means spending nights at the telescope trying to catch the star and observing it for a period of time, hoping that the atmosphere and weather conditions allow us to do so. But the weather is perhaps only the first of an astronomer's problems. For instance, when it comes to the study of very old stars, astronomers expect them to show really specific features. Among these, they expect such stars to be really poor in metals. This is because assuming that these stars actually existed, they must have been born in an environment that was full of hydrogen and helium, but very depleted of heavier elements. These stars are known as Population 3 stars, but unfortunately, we never managed to observe one so far. Even though scientists think they might still exist somewhere in the universe, finding them is no walk in the park. Just like all other stars, the population of 3 stars started slowly fusing their elements, turning them into heavier ones. This is how the first metals were created in the universe. Afterwards, these heavier elements were used in processed by the population of two stars, to which, for example, Methuselah belongs. As you can understand the life and death of population 3 and 2 stars provided the universe with the key elements to the formation of stars, just like our sun, that eventually were capable of having planets forming around them and sustaining life as we know it. These younger stars, with a variety of heavy elements, belong to the so-called population 1 star. Determining the age of the population of two stars like Methuselah is a really challenging task, because astronomers rely on the measurements of the gas absorption lines coming from the heavy elements present in the outer layers of the star. If the star contains very little of these elements, the accuracy in terms of age goes down, and the uncertainties rise. It's like trying to tell the size of a house from a very long distance. Even though you know the average size of a house, your estimate will be affected by errors in the way you carried out your measurements, because you missed the small details that were not visible from that huge distance. The importance of better estimates. The story of Methuselah stresses the importance of having updated measurements, made with different instruments and using different approaches. This not only applies to the age of stars, but also to the age of the universe. What we expect to happen in the next decades is to come up with techniques that allow us to detect really faint lines in the stars whose heavy elements abundances are very low, so that we might get better estimates for stars like Methuselah. On the other hand, we should never stop questioning the validity of our theories, because that is the only way science can develop. That's the only way we can understand the universe and, ultimately, ourselves. Hey, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you think Methuselah could disprove the Big Bang Theory? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.